Hello friends, the gymnosperms are known as the plants with naked seed. But the another identity of gymnosperms is that this is the group of plants which was dominant once on the earth. Gymnosperms were the companions of the great dinosaurs. But in the time period of the evolution, many gymnosperms became extinct. Today, their distribution is restricted to certain space on the earth and they are represented by only few living genera. In this video, we will discuss the general characteristics of gymnosperms. During this discussion, you will come to know why they are restricted and why number of species became extinct. I am Sudhakar and you are watching Science Knowledge with Sudhakar. The term gymnosperm includes two terms, gymno, sperma. Gymno means naked and the sperma means seeds. So these are the plants with naked seeds. As the ovules are produced without ovary, the gymnosperms are also called as phanerogams without ovary. The gymnosperms were originated during the Devonian period of the Paleozoic era. This is a part of geological time scale where the total life of Earth is divided in number of eons, eras, and then periods. The Earth is estimated to be originated about 4.6 billion years ago. The first gymnosperm was originated somewhere in the Devonian period. Then it proliferated during the Carboniferous period, Permian, Triassic, and Jurassic period, up to the Cretaceous period. Here we can see the Jurassic period was also dominated by the dinosaurs. So during the era of dinosaurs, gymnosperms were dominant. This figure shows the distribution of various plants on the earth at various times. We can see the gymnosperms were originated somewhere in the Devonian period. So this column represents gymnosperms. At the Jurassic and Cretaceous period, we can see that most of the space on the earth was occupied by gymnosperms. At that time, the angiosperms just started to originate. Today, the gymnosperms are distributed in the tropical and temperate regions of the world. You might have identified what is meant by tropical and temperate zone. So the earth is divided in two equal parts. At the zero axis, we call it as equator. From equator towards north 23 and south 23 degree, we have the tropical region. And up to 60 degree north and 60 degree south, we get temperate region. The gymnosperms distributed in these two regions. At present, gymnosperms are represented by 70 genus, which are the living one, and about 725 species. The habit includes woody nature of gymnosperm. Note that all the gymnosperms are woody. They are perennial forms, that means they live for many years. The habitat which is occupied by gymnosperms is xerophytic habitat. The gymnosperms either grow at high altitudes, like as in Himalayan ranges, where there will be rainfall, but the water will not be retained by the soil. So finally, the conditions will be xerophytic. Similarly, the gymnosperms are dominant in deserts and along the sea coast. In gymnosperms, we get various forms. Many gymnosperms show the shrubby and tree appearance. In this figure also, we can see how the gymnosperms appears like as huge trees. Few of the gymnosperms are climbers, but as these climbers produces wood, they are called as Lina. So woody climbers are called as Lina. Note this point, number of times this question has been asked in university examinations. The example of Lina is Gnetum ula. Gnetum ula is distributed in western ghats of the Sahyadri, India. The gymnosperms produces a tap root system. That means the roots which are produced from the radical remains persistent. So they form tap root system. In few of the plants, we can see the coralloid roots. For example, in Cycas, we get coralloid roots. Coralloid roots are the small roots which are produced near the soil surface. They are negatively geotropic, that means they tend to come out of the soil. They show endosymbiotic association with nitrogen fixer bacteria, cyanobacteria. So they take part in nitrogen fixation. With reference to stem, we get two types of gymnosperms. In certain gymnosperms, like as a Cycas, the stem is unbranched. Here this is a Cycas, and we can see that the stem is columnar, unbranched stem. In certain cases, the accidentally or due to formation of injuries, the Cycas may show branching, but this is not the general trait in the Cycas. In coniferous plants, the stem is a branched one. The branches are of two types. So they are called as a dimorphic. Morphologically, we have two types of branches. Certain branches are of the limited growth. That means they will grow for a particular season. Whereas certain branches are branches of unlimited growth. That means they will continue their growth in many seasons or many years. Usually, the branches of limited growth are produced on the branches of unlimited growth. The dimorphic branches can be seen in conifers like as a Pinus. We can see a variety of leaves in gymnosperms. In Cycas, we have compound leaves. So Cycas leaves includes a rachis and pinnately compound leaflets are there. Pinnately compound leaf is the characteristic of cycads, and this shows a resemblance with the pteridophytes. In pines, we get needle-like leaves, whereas simple leaves can be seen in Gnetum. In this way, we have a variety of leaves in the gymnosperms. There are two types of leaves in gymnosperm. So again, the leaves are dimorphic. Certain leaves are scaly. The scaly leaves are brown in color. They are non-photosynthetic and provide protection to the apical meristem. The photosynthetic leaves are green and their function is to produce food. About the vascular bundle, together it is called as a stele. In gymnosperm, the stele type is Siphonostele. That means a parenchymatous pith is present at the center of the vascular system and it produces a pipe-like structure. No doubt, later on this pith get crushed, but initially we have a pith parenchyma in the center of the vascular system. So such type of wood is called as Siphonostele wood. The xylem consists of only tracheids. The vessels are absent in most of the gymnosperms. The vessels can be recorded in nettles, and that is why nettles are said to be most evolved gymnosperms, or these are the gymnosperms which shows resemblance with angiosperms. This picture shows the transverse section of the Pinus stem. The xylem is the red colored zone, whereas at center we can see the parenchymatous pith. The primary xylem is present at the center, and later on the secondary xylem will cover the primary xylem. The secondary xylem shows presence of tracheids. The tracheids which are produced during the monsoon season, rainy season, are larger and they have less thickening as compared to the tracheids which are produced in the summer season or drier season. That is why in each year we get a separate ring of the tracheal elements. Such rings which are present in the vascular system, they are called as annular rings. These cavities are the resin canals. Don't confuse it with the vessels. Vessels are absent. The phloem shows presence of sieve tubes and phloem parenchyma, but the companion cells are absent. The wood is of two types. In number of conifers, we get pycnoxylic wood. Pycnoxylic wood is a dense wood where the tracheary elements are arranged compactly with each other. So this pycnoxylic wood has a compact arrangement of tracheids, and that is why it has huge economic value as a timber wood. The manoxylic wood is produced by cycads, where the tracheary elements are loosely arranged and the tracheids are separated by presence of parenchyma. Such wood forms a fibrous wood and it cannot be used for building purpose. The reproductive organs are produced in a compact cone. These cones are non-attractive as the calyx and the corolla is absent. The plants are dioecious. Morphologically, we get two different types of plants. Male plants will be separate from female plants. That means if the plant produces male reproductive structure, it will only produce male reproductive structure throughout its life. So this plant will be unisexual and male plant, whereas the another plant will be unisexual female plant. They produces two types of spores. The male plant produces microspore, whereas the female plant produces megaspore. As the spores are of two types, the gymnosperms are called as heterosporous. The male cones are usually small and herbaceous in nature. They are produced in cluster and they have many microsporophylls. This picture shows the male cone of Pinus. We can see that there are many male cones produced in the cluster. They are small, of the size of about a finger, herbaceous in nature. The female cones are large. They are woody and perennial. In case of Pinus, the female cone takes 3 years for maturity. In case of Cycas, the female cone are loosely arranged. They are called as megasporophyll. The ovules are naked. They are orthotropous in nature and unitegmic. The mode of pollination is anemophilous pollination. That means they are pollinated by wind. No specific pollinator insect, bird, bat, or any animal is associated with the pollination of gymnosperms. And this is one of the major drawbacks for its restriction. Now, in anemophilous pollination, the seed set will happen only when the pollen grains will reach to the receptive female gamete, that is the receptive ovule. Now, these microspores, if not reached in time to this ovule, then there will be no seed setting. And as there is a less number of seed set, these plants cannot migrate or they cannot occupy the space away from the mother plant. Most of the gymnosperms, they reproduce with the help of bulbils. And bulbils cannot move far away from the mother parent. And that is why the gymnosperms are now restricted to certain space on the earth. The seeds are naked. Let us note the tallest gymnosperm and the smallest gymnosperm. So by height, the tallest gymnosperm is Sicyphia sempervirens. This is the plant with the height of 112 meters. By the size, that means by the biomass production, we have giant Sicyphia as the largest gymnosperm. The smallest gymnosperm is Zamia pygmaea. Again, note these two names because these are important one with reference to objective questions. So here we complete the general characteristics of gymnosperm. I hope you might have understood why the gymnosperms are restricted to certain area and why most of the gymnosperms became extinct in the period of evolution. If you find this video really helpful, then please like, share and subscribe my channel. See you in next video. Till then, bye bye. Thank you.